Have you used SQL Assessments and SQL Server on Azure Virtual Machines? Learn all about it this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Ebru, a program manager on the SQL Server team. Thanks so much for joining us today.
Thanks for having me, Anna.
Always a pleasure. And today we're going to be talking about some new capabilities available for SQL Server running in Azure Virtual Machine. Why don't you kick us off by telling us a little bit about this and maybe a little bit of history or context?
Sure. So SQL Assessment is all about making sure your SQL Server is configured properly, that it's following configuration best practices. And we have SQL Assessment API, which is part of SQL Server PowerShell module and SMO. And on top of that API, now we built a user experience in Azure portal specifically for SQL Server on Azure Virtual Machines.
Okay, cool. So this is something that's kind of been around for a while, but now it's available directly in the portal for SQL Server running on Azure Virtual Machines. So I think it would be great or awesome if you could just take us through it. What does it look like? What can we find? That sort of thing.
Sure, I'd love to. Okay, so if you have a SQL Server on Azure VM 2012 or higher version and registered with SQL IS extension, then you'll see this feature SQL Assessment on the SQL VM page. And I can show you how to enable and all that, but I want to first start by showing you all the recommendations and what you would get out of this feature. This is the fun part, right? So we store the results in your Logantix workspace, and we show the results in a workbook. And this workbook has a lot of information, so I'll walk you through it. We're looking at results, assessment results, collected at this specific date and time. And from this dropdown, you can reach all the results. And we're looking at all the issues. You can see here in this chart how many you pass and how many you need to do something about, broken down by severity. We have high, medium, low, and informational severity levels. And this bottom part is where the recommendations are. So this first grid shows you all the recommendations grouped. And by grouped, I mean it shows you for each recommendation how many times it occurred in your environment. And if you click on one of these recommendations, you'll see, for example, this particular information, it's high severity, it's in the performance area or memory area. Tags tell you which area the recommendation falls under. And this particular recommendation is for your server. And we're saying, please enable the lock pages in memory option. And if you click on it, you'll get a little bit more information about why we're telling you to enable this option. And if you want to further read about it, you can follow this link.
Cool.
So we have, let's get some more recommendations. This one, for example, is about full backups. We're recommending that you have full backups not older than a week. And in this particular environment, these three databases all hit this issue. So you see three instances of the same recommendation here. We run the assessment against the server and all the databases. We have recommendations. Some of them are specific to SQL Server on Azure VMs. Like we're recommending that you, for these databases, you move the data files from the C drive to premium SSD data disks. But most of our recommendations are generic SQL Server recommendations. Like if you were telling you there's a specific foreign key you have, but there's no corresponding index, so that's not a good situation. Or you can have unused indexes, right? You create an index, but it's not being used. You should probably check it out and remove it if it's actually not used. So this is a demo environment. That's why we have like one of these. In an actual production environment, you can imagine there'll be multiples of these. And if you clear the selection in this first grid, actually, you'll see all the recommendations we have for your environment. And like I said, in a production environment, that'll be thousands, like 4,000 or 5,000 wow. recommendations.
And you can use the severity to kind of figure out which ones you should do first.
Exactly. That's what I was going to talk about. That just looking at thousands of results in a grid is like, how do you go through it, right? That's why we have these filters here. You can filter by focusing on just your instance or any particular database you care about. Or you can filter by severity, like you said. Yeah, we obviously recommend you start with high severity issues. You can filter by area. You might want to focus on performance first, or you might want to make sure your trace flags are set properly. Just pick the area you're interested in. Or you can select any of the recommendations. This is the same as clicking on one of these rows here. Another option you have is exporting these recommendations to Excel. You know, Excel is good with dealing with large amounts of data. Or if you're familiar with Kusto or Log Analytics Query Language, you can open it in the window. I'm not going to show it, but it just opens it in the Log Analytics Query Editor, and you can see the data that way.
Awesome. This is really cool. I had a question. Sure. Maybe we're going to get to it. It looks like this was done on a particular day at a particular time, and you showed us we have historical runs. How mm-hmm. often does this run, or how often do you recommend people run it?
We expect people to run it weekly or, you know, monthly maybe, because the configuration doesn't change that often, right? So that depends on your environment, but probably weekly is the most common we see. And speaking of doing multiple runs, we also give you some views into what happened in this run, right? You did one run, you looked at all the issues. In the next run, you want to see just what's new now. You can see that in this tab. Or if you fixed some issues, you want to confirm that those things are resolved since the last run. So you can use those tabs for that.
Nice.
All right. So let's go back and see how we enable SQL assessments to get to all these results. And it's quite simple, really. All you need to do is tell us your Log Analytics workspace name, because that's where we're going to store the results. This VM is already associated with one, so it's grayed out. But if it wasn't, this dropdown would give you a list of all the available workspaces in that subscription. So you would just pick the one that works for you. And the other thing you can do is enable scheduling. You can do this at enable time, or you can do this, you know, from the configuration button anytime. So you can do an assessment anytime on demand, right? But you can also set a schedule so we can run this automatically for you. And like we talked about, we have weekly or monthly options with, you know, all the day of week, occurrence, and time you set, and then automatic run happens for you. And once you hit apply, we install Microsoft Monitoring Agent for you if it's not already installed, and configure it to talk to your Log Analytics workspace. That's the agent is going to upload your results. And then we also deploy SQL Assessment as well. So I'll show you another machine where we enabled it and did some runs. As you can see now, Run Assessment is enabled. This is the on-demand run. You can, by clicking on this button, you can do a run anytime you want. And on the bottom half, you see like the last 10 runs you've done. And if you set a schedule, you'll also see when your next run is scheduled for. If there's a failure, you can click on it and see more about the failure. For example, if you set your Log Analytics workspace to, you know, clean up after a while, your results might disappear. And here's recommendation on how to fix that. And yeah, by clicking on this button here, I mean, this link, then that takes you to the workbook I just showed you here.
Gotcha. Cool. This is really awesome.
Thanks. That's mostly what I wanted to talk about. There's a couple more things in the workbook, but you can discover them on your own. The most important part is just understanding what the recommendations are doing and just following up on the high severity ones to start with.
Awesome. Thanks so much, Ebru. This has been really useful. I've certainly learned a lot about SQL assessments and then even some of the best practices around using SQL assessments. For folks that might be just getting started with SQL assessments, do you have any tips or tricks or advice?
I would say just try it on one of your systems and, you know, learn the assessment feature and then just start using it everywhere. We really think this will bring a lot of value to you because this is SQL Server teams, you know, years of experience, best practices provided to you. So we hope you make use of it.
Awesome. Great. Well, thanks again for coming on the show to our viewers. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, go ahead, give it a like. Comment and let us know what you think of SQL assessments. We'll put links in the description for you to learn more, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.